What's the one weird thing God expects of you? Well, that question was once asked of 20th century evangelist and teacher W.E.N. Thomas. Major Thomas' response was classic. What's the one thing God expects of you? He said, failure. Are you ready for some good news? Unlike most people, God is attracted to your weaknesses, failures, and pain. He came like a physician for the sick. Consider the scene from Luke chapter 4. The visiting rabbi was no stranger to Nazareth. He was a hometown boy. The fame of the carpenter's son had begun to spread, and the local synagogue leaders were glad to welcome the rising star as their guest teacher for the day. The synagogue authorities handed him the scroll of the reading from the prophets. Per Jewish custom, the young rabbi stood up and read the assigned text, a selection that likely had been set as much as a year or two in advance. His audience waited expectantly to hear his interpretation. Would he be as wise and eloquent as others had said? Would his exposition of the Isaiah text reveal an inspiring new angle of thought? They never could have imagined it. When the Nazarene opened his mouth, he shocked them to the core. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me. And then he said, "Today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." Jesus wasn't just a teacher of ancient texts. He was the fulfillment of them. The Isaiah scripture, which Jesus read in Nazareth, highlights the Messiah's mission. He was anointed to minister to the poor, the captive, the blind, the oppressed. In other words, your greatest qualification for Jesus' ministry is your dire need of him. We're conditioned by culture to hide our weaknesses, blame others for our failures, and pretend we're okay. But there's no need to hide from an all-knowing God. He knows you fully. He knows all your past mistakes and your future sins. Thus, he cannot be disillusioned with you at any point. The sooner you accept that his love and mercy are set upon you without regard for your merit, the sooner you can be free. So bring your honest, weak self directly to God in the throne room of his grace and discover the depths of his love. No amount of failure can quench the love of God for you. And that's the gospel. Well, that's today's daily devotional. You can get more like it by clicking right here, or better yet, subscribe. Start out every day with good news. Remember today, God's love for you is unquenchable.